Hi folks, Mark again here at Family Fun Scuba and Snorkel, located in Billings, Montana. Today I wanted to go over some boat diving tips. This will be part one, so that you don't have to go through baptism by fire when you're out there in the water. The bottom line is, we'd rather have you prepared and ready for anything. So let's get started. Number one, when you're boat diving, always make sure you're on time. This is good etiquette anywhere. Especially boat diving. Other people don't want to have to wait and having you get ready last minute or running to the docks or what have you. So always be on time. Number two, make sure you ask for permission to come aboard the boat. Bottom line is, this is good naval procedure, and you know, it's just a commonality that's been in maritime permissions for forever. So always make sure that you ask permission to come aboard. Number three, check, double check, 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 double check, trip check, so on and so forth, your gear before you get on the boat. There's nothing worse than having a piece of gear that you need and you don't have it. The bottom line is, it's better to have extra and not need it than to not have it and need it. So always bring a little extra. Also your buddies and, you know, other folks that are on board might really appreciate you if you have something very simple that they could really use. Number four, have a small portable save a dive kit with you. What are a couple things you could bring? Well, number one, in my opinion, O-rings, hair ties, zip ties, maybe a mass strap, fin straps, you know, just some very simple things that can really help you out, a multi-tool. These are just some really simple things that can fit inside of a box that your mask comes in. It doesn't take up hardly any room, and boy, it's worth its weight in gold. Know the temperature, number six, know the temperature, not only that it is outside, but also be aware of the sun. A lot of us aren't used to the sun and temperatures when we go on these vacations or excursions, and need to be aware. A lot of boats will have an open section on the end near the motor, and then a canopy over the top which provides shade. Yet another good reason to be on time, and early for that matter, is if you're not a person that's super friendly with sun, you may want to get underneath that canopy so you can stay out of it. Now if you're under there, of course, you can always come out, go out to the water, look around, maybe go up and see the captain if they're good with that. But be aware of the sun, not only for sunblock to protect your skin, but you know, making sure you don't get dehydrated. A lot of dives, people will see gear that they're not used to and so on and so forth. Kind of a good procedure is to ask people for permission if you want to see their gear. Don't just go up and touch it. Ask them. Ask questions. People love to talk about their gear, love to talk about their dives and how they use it. And you know, ask them if they can see it. We don't want to spoil that between two divers when somebody's fiddling with somebody else's gear. Moving on, when you do finally get in the water, if you had gotten paired up with somebody that you don't know, or even maybe somebody you do know, and they're not a good dive partner, you need to get a new partner. Yeah, it may seem like it's rude or a little rash, but it's not, it's your life. So make sure you got a good dive partner that's attentive to you, stays close to you, and is prepared to help you. You should also, of course, do your pre-dive check with them, making sure that all your equipment is not only where it's supposed to be, that it's on, and is very operable. Number 10, always make sure that you have your safety devices. Whether it be a SMB whistle, a mirror for flashing, it could be anything, cutting devices, scissors, yeah, so there's just all kinds of things where you could need something, maybe even a pair of gloves to help somebody out, or if you're wreck diving or you're going down a trail, or not a trail line, but a buoy line where there's hooks and crustaceans and all that stuff, you know, just keep your hands safe. Moving forward, number 11, which is too commonly blown off, is listen to the dive brief. Yes, I know some of us have heard them 1,000 times, but these people that are taking us out on these guided trips, they know this area better than anybody. Listen to it. Take the time to do so. Also, it's just you know, kind of rude not to listen to them when they're taking their time out for you. So, you know, be friendly. Kindness is free. And listen to the dive breathe. When you're on the boat, when you're boarding, make sure that you locate the safety equipment. Know where buoys are, life jackets, where the reserve boat that is used in case of a sink emergency. Know what the local channel is for emergency stations. Know where the fire extinguisher is. Know all these things. And you know what? If you don't know, ask. The squeaky wheel will get oiled. And just ask. It's okay. If you don't ask, you won't know. So squeak away. Make sure a couple things that you want to have with you. Number one would definitely be a dry bag, because you want to keep your dry stuff dry. Of course, have warm clothes, towel in there, sunscreen, maybe a hat, sunglasses. You'll also want to bring your own food and snack. Most boats will provide that, but you always want to make sure you have it. I have been on excursions before where water has been forgotten, and there were not happy divers. Very, very dehydrated divers, which is problem number one. If you have long hair, again, make sure you have hair ties. But here's a good hint for you. If you do have longer hair, it's really neat to put some reef-friendly conditioner in your hair, get it all through, just go dive. When you come out, it'll comb out really nice. There won't be the snarls and stuff that you'll normally see. And then when you rinse it out on the boat, put a little coconut oil in it. It's great. Just worked wonderfully. I know we're all anxious to get into the water when we get going, but be patient. No different than when you're in the water, slow down, be patient, just relax and think. There's a couple things you always want to make sure you know before you walk back to the edge of the boat, or before you dip backwards into the water. Of course, make sure your tank is on. It happens. Please make sure you have that on. You should be doing your buddy check and your buddy reassuring you, but ultimately, you are the certified diver. It's your responsibility. Also, make sure that you have your mask. Put it around your neck. People do go back without their masks to the back of the boat to do their giant stride. Make sure you have your mask, make sure it's defogged and ready to go. And yes, this also happens. People go to the back of the boat and they won't have their fins. Make sure you got your fins either on foot or in hand so that you can put them on at the end of the boat or after your giant stride in. These kind of funny things do happen. If you've got cameras, make sure that you have your camera and that it was in the appropriate dunk tank to get it accustomed to water. Make sure there's no leaks and so on and so forth. Make sure you have that. Any dive lights you may need. Make sure you have all those things, and again, your gloves. A lot of this stuff fits great in your pockets. I can't stress enough, it's better to have more and not need it than to need something and not have enough. You can always make a little separate ditty bag or a little container, your own little save a dive bag or kit. Again, I've given out more little tiny pieces of gear over the years than I can shake a stick at, and people have been really appreciative. That's part of what we are as divers, giving back to the community and to each other to help each other out. So to finish up, this is a boat dive number one, and we'll be coming out with the second part here soon. Again, this is Mark with Family Fun Scuba and Snorkel, located in Billings, Montana, at 1841 Grand Ave. And for your locals, that's on the corner of 19th and Grand. Our phone number is 406-860-2590, or feel free to email us at info@familyfunscuba.com. Thanks so much. Hope you have a great day. Pool's open.